It's just love. SourceForge International. Hello, students. Welcome to the SourceForge learning session on the topic of motion for the subject physics for grade 7. So SourceForge is one of the leading names head student in their life goals through schooling, sports and life skills. So let us start our class. This is our second chapter of physics. Chapter name is motion. In this PPT you are going to learn about what is rest and motion and different kind of motion. Then here is the introduction part. In physics, as we know, motion is the phenomenon in which an object changes its position over the time. Motion is what? The movement of an object. That is called motion with a limited time period. Motion is mathematically described in terms of displacement, distance, velocity, acceleration, speed and time. So it depends upon these factors: displacement, distance, velocity, acceleration, speeds and time. Here is I given one picture that is about different type of motion: random motion, translation motion, rotational motion, oscillatory motion. Again, translation motion is divided into rectilinear motion, curvilinear motion and circular motion. We are going to learn about all this type of motion in this chapter. So motion is one of the key topics, very interesting topic in physics. Everything in the universe is in moving. How? You know, Earth is moving in its own axis, and also Earth is moving around the sun. When we are walking also, when we are sitting on the chair, that is also is one kind of motion, because Earth is moving. Though you are not moving, but Earth is moving. That's why you are also in motion. So it might only be a small amount of movement and very very slow, but movement does happen. As I told you, if you are sitting idle in the chair, in that time also you are moving. Don't forget that even if you appear to be standing still, the Earth is moving around the sun, and the sun is moving around the galaxy. The movement never stops. Motion is one of the one part of what physicists called mechanics. In your higher class you are going to learn about mechanics. That is a huge chapter. Over the years, scientists have discovered several rules or laws that explain motion and the cause of changes in motion. There are also special laws when you reach to speed of light or when physicists look at very small things like atoms. This is also different kind of picture of different kind of motion. Example: vibratory motion, linear motion, curvilinear motion. Here is rotational motion, circular motion and oscillatory motion. First come to introduction and what is rest and motion. This page is from your book. As we look around us, we see many objects which are either moving or stationary. Can you imagine an object which is neither moving nor stationary? No, you can't. Thus, we say that every object around us either at rest or in motion. In this lesson, we will learn about the ways in which objects move and understand the terms related to the motion of the object. First come to what do you mean by rest? An object is said to be rest if it does not change any position with time and with respect to its immediate surroundings. That is called the body is at rest, which does not change its position with time and with respect to immediate surrounding. So imagine you are sitting outside and looking at a building nearby. We say the building is at rest. This is because the building does not change its position with time and with respect to you. Then come to another object also in the surroundings. In this figure, you can see this chair is in rest position, this tree also, and this transmission tower. So they are not moving. They are still in their position with respect to time and also with respect to its surrounding. Then come to motion. An object is said to be motion if it changes its position with time and with respect to immediate surrounding. If it will change the position with time and also with respect to their immediate surrounding, that is called the object is in motion. While sitting outside, you may observe that a bus is moving past. We say that the bus is in motion. This is because it is continuously changing its position with respect to you and other objects in the surrounding. This is example, a moving camel cart, a flying bird, and motion of a football. So these all are in motion. Thus, whenever we speak, object at rest or in motion, we say this is this in comparison with the other object surrounding it. Rest and motion are relative terms. How? Imagine you are sitting inside a moving train. Look at the trees, lamp post, houses, people and animals outside. Is there any change in your position with respect to them? Now look at the seats, roof of the train and other passenger in your compartment. What do you observe? If we look outside, we observe one thing. If we look inside the train, we observe another thing. So let's see. You will observe that you are in motion with respect to trees, lampposts, post houses, people and animals outside the train. But you are at rest with respect to the seats and the roof of the train. Thus, a body may be at rest with respect to one object and at the same time in motion with respect to another object. Thus, rest and motions are considered to be relative terms. When we are traveling in the train, we saw outside the train the trees and houses, they are in their places. They are not moving, but train is moving. And though you are sitting inside the train, you are also in moving. But your seats and roof of the train, they are also in their position. But due to train is moving, they are also moving. So this is different kind of motion which is given in your book. First one is translated motion. This is two type, rectilinear and curvilinear. Circulatory motion or rotatory motion, oscillatory motion, vibratory motion, periodic motion. The most important example of periodic motion is simple pendulum. Non-periodic motion, multiple motion and random motion. First we learn translatory motion. The motion of an object in which every point of the object moves through the same distance in the same time interval, that is called translatory motion. So the motion of an object in which every point of the object moves through the same distance in the same time interval. Same distance in the same time interval, that is called translatory motion. For example, a car moving along a road, a ball rolling on the ground, a bullet fire from a gun, an athletic running and a boy going down a slide. So these are the example of translatory motion. Next come to translatory motion are two types. One is rectilinear, another curvilinear. Rectilinear, the object along a straight line. The motion of an object along a straight line, that is called rectilinear. It is also called linear motion. For example, a car moving along a straight road, a ball falling down in a straight path, athletic running on a straight racing track, a coin moving on undeflected over a carom board. These are all the example of rectilinear motion. Come to curvilinear, an object along a curve line, that is called curvilinear. For example, a car is taking a turn. When a car is moving in a straight line and suddenly it will take a curve, that is called curvilinear motion. Javelin thrown a athlete and basketball thrown into a basket. These are the example of curvilinear, means the motion of an object along with a curve line, that is called curvilinear. And the motion of an object along a straight line, that is called rectilinear. Then come to circulatory motion. What do you mean by circulatory motion? The motion of an object about a fixed point or a fixed axis along the circumference of a circle without changing its position, that is called circulatory motion or rotatory motion. The motion of an object about a fixed point, this is the fixed point, and along the circumference of a circle, that is called circulatory motion. Example, a spinning top, heart spinning on its axis, a spinning wheel, rotating fan. These are the example of circulatory motion. So this is also example of circulatory motion. In physics, circulatory motion is a movement of an object along its circumference of a circle or rotation along a circular path. It can be uniform with constant angular rate of rotation and constant speed, or non-uniform. It can be uniform or non-uniform with changing rate of rotation. So circulatory motion is also known as rotatory motion. Then come to oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion means the motion of an object in which the object moves to and fro or back and forth about its mean position, means its rest position, is called oscillatory motion. The motion of an object which moves to and fro or back and forth about its rest position or mean position, that is called oscillatory motion. The best example for oscillatory motion is pendulum, motion of pendulum. The motion of pendulum, the motion of swing, the motion of mass suspend by a string, and the motion of the piston of an engine are example of oscillatory motion. So today you learn oscillatory motion, circulatory motion, translatory motion. Translatory motion also two type, rectilinear and curvilinear motion. This is also some information about oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion is defined as to and fro motion of an object from its mean position, that is rest position. The ideal condition is that the object can be oscillatory motion forever in the absence of friction, but in the real world this is not possible. Absence of friction is not possible, and the object has to settle into its equilibrium. So this is all about oscillatory motion. Okay, you can see this recorded video in YouTube, and this is the end of this session, and next class we will continue with this motion. Thank you.